chant Om Namah Shivaya twice. Please repeat after me. Go.
Shivaya.
please be relaxed. Sit in a comfortable posture. Sthirasukham Asanam. The posture in which I am sitting, my body is steady and comfortable. Eyes are lightly closed. The hands are resting in the lap, or however it is convenient to you. This meditation is an appointment with myself. An appointment with myself. Normally, I'm so busy or preoccupied. I do not have an opportunity to be acquainted with my own self. Therefore, this is the occasion when I spend a quality time with myself. When I have no other agenda. There is no agenda in my mind. Seeking to accomplish anything. I'm not seeking any new experience. I'm not seeking any new sensation. I just want to be what I am. Because Vedanta teaches me that I'm all right as I am. I do not have to become different from what I am. I am all right as I am. And therefore, I am comfortable with myself. Because I accept myself as I am. Accept my body and is I lovingly accept my body. I know that my body is not perfect. But I also know that regardless of what I do, the body will never be perfect. This body is a great gift from the Lord. I am very privileged to have this human body. Where there is potential of learning and growing. I am very happy with my body, whether male or female. Young or not so young. Strong or not so strong, healthy or not so healthy, whatever the body is, I gracefully, lovingly accept it. I have no complaint against my body. Comfortable with my body, with all its virtues and limitations. I am comfortable with my mind. Lovingly accept my mind. My mind also is a great gift from the Lord. Only as a human being I have the privilege of having this mind. Which can feel, which is sensitive, which can love, which can think, which can know, which can grow. It is true that my mind is limited. My power to know is limited. My power to retain is limited. My power to remember is limited. It is true that my mind is limited. But that is how it is meant to be. Whatever is created is limited. My body is created. is limited. My mind also is part of creation, and therefore mind also is limited. But it is a great faculty. Very happy with my mind. With all the amazing functions it can perform. With my mind I feel. With my mind I know. With my mind I remember. With my mind, I communicate. My mind is a great gift from the Lord. I'm privileged to have this human mind. I know that my mind has limitations. Sometimes it gets angry. Sometimes it feels jealous. Sometimes it is sad. But I lovingly accept my mind with all its limitations and virtues. I lovingly accept my body. I lovingly accept my mind. I lovingly accept myself. With my successes and failures. With my gains and losses. With my accomplishments and lack of accomplishments. However I am, I lovingly accept myself as I am. I know that I'm not perfect. I also know that nothing in the creation is perfect. And therefore, I lovingly accept myself with my virtues and limitations. Self-acceptance. That is a problem that I have with myself. That more often than not, I do not accept myself. Very often, I am not kind to myself. keep making demands on myself that I should be different from what I am. Very often, I'm trying to become someone else. But all that is not necessary. I do not have to become someone else. I'm all right as I am. Everyone enjoys a unique place in the scheme of things. An elephant has its place, an ant has a place, a mountain has a place, a pebble has a place. The sun and moon have their places, a star has a place, a lamp has a place. Everything has its place in the universe, in the scheme of things. So also, I have a place in the scheme of things. I may not be like someone else, but I do not have to be like someone else. I am all right as I am. Because that is how the Lord has made me. This is the place the Lord has given me. And therefore, I enjoy my uniqueness. I do not make demands upon myself that I should be different. I lovingly accept everything about myself. My virtues and my limitations. I will change whenever I find it necessary to improve myself. But I will not reject myself. There is acceptance of myself. Comfort with myself. I'm not seeking anyone else's approval. Because I have the approval from the Lord who has made me what I am. Everyone is unique and enjoys a unique place in the scheme of things. I also enjoy that uniqueness. is when there is self-acceptance. I'm at peace with myself. When the self-acceptance is not there, I'm in conflict with my own self. When the self-acceptance is, I am at peace with myself. Where there is peace, there is satisfaction. When there is peace, there is happiness. In self-acceptance, there is peace. When there is peace, there is happiness. In fact, that is my nature. Peace and happiness is my nature. This body, the sense organs, the mind, all of that is my personality. I'm the person possessing the personality. Everyone's personality is unique. But the person is the same. The person that I am is a person that everybody else is. The person that I am is a conscious being. Consciousness is my nature. Simple consciousness I am. Consciousness is silence. Consciousness is peace. Consciousness is satisfaction. That is my true nature. The personality, namely the body, the sense organs, the mind, all this simply the vehicle of manifestation. The body, the sense organs, the mind, I am not. I manifest through them, I express through them. self-existing, self-shining. It is not that I am because the body is. It is not that I am because the mind is. I am because I am. Body is because I am. Mind is because I am. I am silent, formless consciousness. I can see this fact about myself. But there's no conflict in the mind. When the mind is silent, then I can see this fact about myself. The silent consciousness is my nature. Independent of the body, independent of the mind, independent of the personality. I am self-existing, self-shining consciousness. Chidananda-rūpaḥ Shivoham Shivoham. Chidananda-rūpaḥ Shivoham. Shivoham Shivoham. Shivoham Shivoham.